Hello, my friend. Welcome to your sleep story. My name is Stephen Dalton. I'm an Irish storyteller, and it's my great privilege to be the voice that you listen to as you go to sleep tonight. Tonight is another chapter in my series, Rainy Days in the Cafés of the World. In these sleep stories, you get to visit a café in one of the great cities of the world. A nice cozy place. And read and soak up the atmosphere and learn about the city you are in. And tonight, you'll visit Lisbon. I hope you like it. If you want the video to end at a particular point, YouTube allows you to set a timer in the settings. And don't forget to disable autoplay to avoid ads from upcoming videos. Okay, let's do the relaxation session now, which will take a few minutes before tonight's sleep story. I'm going to count down from 10 to 1. And as I do, allow yourself to let go more and more. 10. Feel the support beneath you. Your bed. And the ground beneath that. Feel the support of the earth, our home. Feel the solidity of it, the constantness of it. See if that awareness can allow you to let go just a little bit more. Nine. You are safe. Allow my voice to be an anchor of safety tonight. To be a comfort, a guide, to bring you to sleep, a friend. 8. Feel into your body now. Notice any tension remaining. Any pain? Anywhere you might be holding still? Maybe in your feet? Maybe in your hands? Maybe in your belly? Or in your face? Just let it all go now. Your body has worked hard for you today. It's time to let it rest. 7. Notice the peace within you. Peace lives within you. It's always there, just waiting to be noticed, to be felt. Notice that peace now. 6. This is your time. Your time for rest. You deserve this time. You deserve rest. We all do. Allow that fact to enable you to let go a little bit more now. Five. The day is done. Whatever will be, will be. Whatever has been, has been. All you have is this moment. So enjoy it. Luxuriate in it. The opportunity of rest. Any thoughts that you might have about the day that just was, or the days to come, they do not serve you now. So just see them arrive. Acknowledge them. Say hello to them. But then let them go. Watch them float away like leaves on a river. Four. Perhaps allow a little gratitude now for this moment, for the ability to just lie here and listen to a cozy sleep story, moving closer and closer towards sleep. Three. Begin to engage with your imagination now. Begin to see a colorful and beautiful city. The city of Lisbon. Begin to get a sense of the environment, the smells and sounds and sights, the people, the architecture. Two. Feel into your body again. And notice if you're still holding anywhere. 1. Completely letting go now. As I tell you, tonight's sleep story. You are in Lisbon. And you wander the narrow cobblestone streets. The air is crisp, and it carries with it the scent of the sea and the faint aroma of freshly baked pastéis de nata from nearby bakeries. The sound of fado music drifts from an open window. It has a melancholy, but such a beauty, that echoes off the ancient buildings that line these winding pathways. As you meander through the Alfama district, the oldest part of Lisbon, the tightly packed houses, painted in an array of pastel colors, lend a storybook quality to your surroundings. The iconic Tram 28 rattles by, filled with tourists and locals alike, adding a lively buzz to the serene afternoon. Suddenly, the sky, which had been a clear expanse of blue, begins to darken. Clouds roll in from the Atlantic Ocean, transforming the day in minutes. The first drops of rain fall, light at first, then growing more persistent. Rounding a corner, you stumble upon a quaint little cafe tucked away from the main streets. It feels like you've found a little secret in this so well-known city. Its windows are adorned with wrought iron grills, and there's a little wooden door, weathered by time, with a sign above it that promises coffee and treats. You push the door open, and you're greeted by the rich aroma of coffee beans and the sight of locals engaged in quiet conversation. The cafe is so cozy. It has wooden floors and vintage furniture. You could be walking back in time. It feels like the pace of life is slower here, and the rain outside only adds to the coziness. You approach the counter, greeted by the very welcoming smile of the barista. The people in Lisbon are warm, and this person is no exception. You opt for a galão, the Portuguese version of a latte. The barista expertly prepares your drink, and soon you are scanning for a place to sit, you notice a cozy nook by the window. Its cushioned seat, inviting you to settle in and to make yourself comfortable. The seat you sit in is old. You wonder what its journey has been. How many houses it has lived in. How many scenes from Lisbon's history has it witnessed? From here, you become an observer of moments. A couple at the table across, their heads bent close together in intimate conversation. A solitary figure by the bookshelf, engrossed in a dog-eared novel. And near the entrance, an elderly man who sips his coffee with a leisurely pace, watching the rain-soaked world outside with a contented gaze. He has the look of someone who has been through much, but now sits on the other side, enjoying his life. As you sip your galao, the warmth of the drink spreads through you, mirroring the warmth of the space you found yourself in. Outside, the rain continues its dance on the cobblestones, but inside, in this place, time seems to slow. Then, from the comfort of your seat, you notice an old woman setting up her stall just outside the cafe's window, braving the steady rain that is falling upon her. She arranges her vegetables and fruit with meticulous care, each item she handles as if she has grown them herself. She probably has, you think. She might not even want to sell them. She looks at them with such fondness. The tomatoes, the leafy vegetables, and the citrus fruits all seem precious to her. Her hands, though aged and weathered from years of labor, move with practiced ease and grace, showcasing the bounty of the land she's likely tended herself. There's a resilience about her, a deep inner strength. This woman has lived he is not one for the modern world, but likes the simplicity of her existence. Occasionally, she glances up from her task, and at one point, your eyes meet through the window. She offers a gentle nod and a smile, and her expression holds a warmth and kindness that travels through the barrier of the glass. Despite the rain, a few intrepid souls stop to browse her selection. They smile and laugh with the woman, and this is a moment that you know will stay with you. You now turn your attention to a well-thumbed travel magazine lying on the table beside your cozy nook. Flipping through its pages, you're drawn to an article titled 48 Hours in Lisbon, Unveiling the Soul of the City. Intrigued, you begin to read. Day 1, morning. Start your journey at the break of dawn with a visit to the historic Belém district. Witness the monument to the discoveries and the UNESCO-listed Geronimos Monastery as they bask in the first light. Their intricate details casting long shadows. Don't miss the chance to taste the world-renowned pastéis de nata at the original pastéis de Belém bakery, where the secret recipe has been guarded since 1837. Afternoon. Head back towards the city center and lose yourself in the narrow streets of Alfama, the oldest neighborhood in Lisbon. Here, the soul of the city comes alive with fado music, echoing from the traditional taverns. Climb up to the São George Castle for panoramic views of the city, sprawled below. Its red roofs and white walls, just a part of the great charm of Lisbon. Evening. As the sun sets, make your way to the vibrant Bairro Alto. This neighborhood comes alive at night with its myriad bars and restaurants, offering the perfect setting to enjoy local cuisine and wine. Experience the youthful energy of Lisbon's nightlife, where the streets resonate with the sounds of laughter and music. Day 2, morning. Begin your second day with a leisurely stroll through the Parc de Nachos, a modern contrast to the historical core of Lisbon. Here, the Oceanário de Lisboa offers an enchanting glimpse into marine life, with its vast collection of species from around the globe. Afternoon. Dedicate your afternoon to exploring the artistic side of Lisbon by visiting the Museum of Art, Architecture, and Technology. Its exhibitions are a dialogue between the past and the future, showcasing Portugal's creative legacy. Later, wander through the LX factory, a former industrial complex turned cultural hub, where local artists and designers showcase their work. Evening. Conclude your 48-hour journey with a sunset cruise along the Tagus River as you glide along the water. Lisbon reveals itself from a different perspective. The reflections of its monuments, shimmering on the surface. It's a moment of tranquility and beauty, encapsulating the soulful essence of the city. You finish the article, and then take some time to simply be. The gentle hum of the cafe is comforting, and with each breath you draw in the rich, complex aroma of coffee. The sound of rain against the window is now a steady, calming presence. You focus on the sensation of the cup in your hands, the warmth seeping into your skin, spreading a comfortable glow throughout your body. This physical anchor to the present moment. This simple pleasure is something to be grateful for. Breathing in, you imagine drawing in this city's vibrant energy, filling your being with the resilience and spirit of Lisbon. Breathing out, you release any lingering thoughts or tensions, letting them dissolve with the rain outside. Perhaps you find solace in the simple act of observing, of listening, and of being fully present in this little cafe in Lisbon, amidst the rain and the stories unfolding around you. You connect with the peace within yourself, and you are reminded, perhaps, of the beauty of simply being. Now you decide to look at the bookshelf. You move through the books and find a rather old-looking book called Tales of Lisbon by João Silva. The protagonist, Miguel, finds himself on a balmy evening in 1950s Lisbon, wandering the streets under the newly installed streetlights that cast soft shadows on the cobblestone. Alone, with only the distant echo of footsteps and the occasional murmur of voices from behind closed shutters for company, the city feels like it's holding its breath, waiting for something, or perhaps someone, to break the silence. Miguel stops at a small overlook where the city unfolds before him. Here, standing on the edge of memory and possibility, he's not searching for anything in particular, but feels a deep connection to the streets of his youth, to the memories that seem etched into the very stones of Lisbon. The earth carries the scent of the ocean, and a dog barks somewhere in the distance. A solitary sound that somehow encapsulates the solitude and the beauty of the night. Taking a deep breath, Miguel lets the unique blend of smells, sounds, and sights fill his senses. He realizes that it's moments like these, simple, quiet, unremarkable to anyone but him, that bring about his deep love for Lisbon. It's not just the city's grandeur or its lively streets that call to him. It's these silent conversations between the city and its inhabitants. Standing at the overlook, Miguel feels peace. He knows that no matter where life takes him, these streets and the tales of Lisbon will always be a part of who he is. You put the book down and just try to imagine that Lisbon of days gone by. A simpler time, perhaps. A time before so many people were visiting. A time when in most cities of the world, it would not be unusual to know a lot of the people you see on the street, to greet them by name. A time when a photograph was a rarity, when you had to remember to pack your camera. A time when information took work to obtain. Breathe in those thoughts. Maybe you feel that simplicity. And it brings about even more peace. Now you are feeling quite sleepy, and you decide that it's time to head back to your hotel. You bid goodbye to your fellow patrons and to the friendly barista. And you walk out into the rain. The streets of Lisbon have quietened now. And as you enter the lobby of your hotel, its welcoming interior strikes you. The hotel has real charm. It's been here a long time. You exchange a smile with the receptionist, whose nod acknowledges your return, and you make your way to your room. The room greets you with its familiar warmth. The bed neatly made, inviting you to lie in it. The window offers a view of Lisbon's evening, a scene now familiar and dear to you. But the softness of the bed beckons you more strongly. You allow yourself to sink into the plush bedding. The cool sheets, a gentle caress against your skin. It's in this peaceful solitude that you find yourself drifting. And as you close your eyes, the gentle rhythm of your own breathing becomes a meditation, leading you into a deep and restful sleep. And as you dream of this enchanting city. This city on the western side of Portugal that boasts so much. You feel safe here. You feel welcome here. And you look forward to continuing your adventure and to being as curious as you want about this amazing place that you are visiting. And as you dream some more, you dream about the cafe, about the friendly people you encountered there, about the coziness that you felt as the rain fell outside, about how you felt so connected to yourself and to the world around you in that moment, and about those people that you studied with such curiosity. The old man and the old woman, where are they now, you think? You are sure they are safe and maybe like you, happily tucked up in bed. And you continue to fold deeper and deeper into the sleep of your dreams in Lisbon.